just got, I want to come on Facebook on tonight. It was really impressed in my spirit to get on tonight to talk about some things. Yes, God. I won't be on here long. It's been a while since I've been on here. But God was really dealing with me about a situation, a matter on tonight. Hallelujah. God, I thank you. It's not going to be much of a popular message, but God wanted me to share something with the people. I want to talk about how we got to be very aware. You got to have your eye gates prepared. You got to have King Spirit in this season. God been dealing with me about these three words, the spirit of camouflage, the imitation spirit, and the spirit of counterfeit. And I want to talk about these three terms because I'm going to tie it in with what he's been dealing with me with. Because we're living in a season right now where you got to be very alert. I want to talk about camouflage first. The definition of camouflage means to hide, to disguise, or mislead the presence of a person, an animal, or an object by painting or covering them to make them, you know, blend in with the surrounding. So I want to talk about that first, how the enemy will camouflage things to deceive his people, to deceive God's people. Then I want to talk about the spirit of imitation. Now, when you imitate something, when the devil imitates something, he's trying to stimulate or copy the appearance or the character of someone or something else. Then I want to define counterfeit. And when something is counterfeit, it's made in exact imitation of something valuable or important with the intention to deceive or defraud. I want you to hear that part again. Made in exact imitation or of something valuable or important with the intention to deceive or defraud. So the counterfeit is like a fraudulent imitation of something else. It's a forgery. It's fake. Counterfeit is fake or made in imitation. For example, we're all familiar with counterfeit money. People making counterfeit money. We've seen it in the movies and things like that. So an example of counterfeit money is that it's not produced by the proper authorities. So I want to talk about how when the enemy counterfeits something, it's not produced by God. It doesn't come from God. So I wanted to talk about how the spirit of counterfeit, the spirit of imitation, the spirit of camouflage, how it's in the land right now. And you got to be very mindful. You got to be very careful. You got to really pray and seek God. You got to really stay in God's word. You got to have your spiritual antennas up. That's what God wanted me to talk about on tonight. Because there are many false teachers. There are many false prophets in the land. There are many false things that are going to come to deceive you, to take you off course, to abort the assignment that God has for you. So I want to talk about that. But what God wanted me to tie that in with is in the scriptures in 1 Kings chapter 13. I want to talk about that. 1 Kings chapter 13, where there was a man of God who was from Judah, and he came to Bethel. You know, God gave him a commandment to go to Bethel. And prior to that, he had met a king, and the king was having issues with his hand. And a man of God prayed to God, and God healed that king. And the king wanted him to come to his house to, you know, eat bread and drink water. But God commanded him not to do that. God told him, he said, I don't want you to eat bread. I don't want you to drink water, nor do I want you to go back the way that you came. So that was the commandment that God gave the man of God. Okay, this was a prophet. He gave him this command. So he goes to Bethel. The man of God goes to Bethel. And the old prophet, who was from Bethel, he had two sons. I'm sorry, that was my phone. He had two sons. And the two sons went to the old man, which was their father. He went to the old man who was a prophet in Bethel. When he heard that the man of God was in town and that he had healed the king, you know, that bothered him because he wanted to see who this guy was. It was almost like, okay, you coming in my town with the pure anointing, and now, you know, I need to meet you. So what he does, he sees the man of God. The old prophet sees the man of God who God sent to Bethel. And he lies and he tells the man of God, who was the prophet, he says that an angel of the Lord came to me and said for you to come to my house so you can eat bread, so you can drink water. So he was lying to the man of God. So the man of God believed him. And he went to the old prophet's house and he ate bread with him and he drank water with him. And so God spoke through the old man, the old prophet who lied to him, and said because he has, you know, disobeyed his commandment and he ate the bread and he drank the water, that, you know, that he was not going to be buried at his father's. What had happened, he ended up leaving the old man's house and got killed by a lion. So what am I saying in all of this? You know, God has given many people instructions. God has given many people assignments. God has told a lot of people what he wants them to do. And the devil is going to try to take you off course. The devil is going to come and try to lie to you. The devil is going to try to come with counterfeit. He's going to come to imitate and camouflage and say that he's of God and he's not going to be of God. So that's what I want to come to warn some people about on tonight. That this is the season that we're living in. We're living in perilous and evil times, and the devil is coming as an angel of light. And I want to encourage people. I want to even encourage single women and even single men, you know, that be careful, you know, because the devil is going to send the counterfeit. He's going to send the imitation that's going to have the appearance and the characteristics that look like God. I'm talking about people that are, you know, looking to wait on God. They're looking for God to do. They're looking for God to send them their blessing. They're looking for God to do the blessing in their life. Okay? The devil's going to send counterfeits that's going to look and seem like the real thing. But you got to be on guard. You got to really listen. You got to really hear, because God is exposing this stuff if you're keen and if you're sharp to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. No matter how bad your flesh may want it, no matter how bad it may look or how good it may sound, no matter how good it may fancy your ears, you have to be on guard. You have to be watchful, because again, the devil is coming as an angel of light. But there's a lot of false stuff coming up, a lot of false antichrist rising up, false teachers, false prophets. They're in the land. They're here. They're not coming. They're here. So you got to be mindful. You got to be girded up in prayer. You got to put on the whole armor of God, because the enemy is not playing. He's bringing distractions. He's bringing all kind of temptations, and you got to stand. You know yourself. You know what you can and can't take. You know what you can and can't handle. You know what you need to do to keep yourself standing. So I just want to encourage somebody on tonight that beware of the counterfeit, beware of the imitation, beware of those that try to blend in and look like sheep and smell like sheep, but really they're on an assignment. They're on an agenda. They have an agenda. They have a hidden agenda. You have to be careful, because we got people right now, we got false teachers all on Facebook now, you know, with the pandemic and some churches being closed down. People not really concerned about the souls of people. They're concerned about the money. They're concerned about the finances. It's a lot of greedy dogs out here. So you got to be very careful. You got to be on guard. You got to be on alert. And when I talked about 1 Kings 13, you know, the man of God was on an assignment and he ended up dying because he listened to this prophet who lied to him. It could have been some jealousy there, because he knew the man of God had came to Bethel in his town and a king had got healed. So you got to be careful that you're not taking off your assignment. You got to be careful that, you know, people will lie and tell you God said, and God really didn't say anything. You know, so you got to make sure you're knowing, because see, when God speaks, it's going to line up with his word. It's not going to line up with what that person wants for you. That, you know, that would benefit them. So when people are saying God said, it needs to line up with the word of God. It's going to confirm what the word of God is saying, not what what that person wants. Because again, I was talking about on Sunday how a lot of people are trying to build their own kingdoms. You know, that's just like with Jezebel in 1 Kings chapter 18. She had her own prophets. You know, it said that Jezebel had, there was 450 prophets of Baal, which was raised up by Jezebel. And then, you know, there were 400 prophets of Asherah. So we got people building their own kingdoms. We got people that want the true people of God to take a back seat while the false go forth. We're living in times right now where people are calling good evil and evil good. You know, they're reversing this thing. You know, people would rather see the false come forth than the real thing. Because see, when God's truth comes forth, when the pure anointing of God comes forth, you know, the light exposes darkness. And a lot of people don't want darkness to be exposed. You know, a lot of people's eyes are blinded. A lot of people's eyes don't see. A lot of people don't see what they're connected to, who they're connected to, and they're wondering why their blessings are being hindered. You know, you never know who you're surrounded around, and they're praying witchcraft against you. They're praying that things don't go forth in your life, and you're wondering why the blessings of God, you know, aren't taking place in your life. You're wondering why you're not moving forth, because sometimes you need to check your connection. You need to check your connection. You need to check who you're connected with. Because again, everything that look like God, that sound like God, I don't care if the gift is moving, because gifts and callings come without repentance. You got to see the fruit of a person. Amen. You know, you got to see the fruit of a person. You got to be a fruit inspector when it comes to people, when they're saying that they're of God. Because if they're constantly messy, if they're constantly stirring up strife, you know, and they say they got the Spirit of God in them, the Holy Spirit don't operate like that. The Holy Spirit, when he's living on the inside of you, he operates in love. He operates in the fruit of the Spirit, which is love, the joy, the peace, the meekness, the gentleness, the temperance, the patience. You know, those are the characteristics of a person who's walking in God's love. Because you have people that come as an angel of light. They come as a wolf in sheep clothing. So people have to take the costumes off. You know, you can't stay in a costume too long. See, the devil can't stay in a costume too long. He gonna get hot under that suit. So eventually, the devil gotta come out. You know, sometimes when you just hear people conversation, you know that there's a trap. You know that there's a setup. So the enemy is setting people up. The enemy is seducing with his seducing spirits. So be on guard. Be on guard. Be on guard. Guard your heart. Guard your heart. Get in prayer. Ask the Lord to give you wisdom. Ask the Lord to give you discernment. Because I'm telling you, these are the times we're living in. These are the times that we're living in. Yes, we're living in these times. Just because it look like a sheep, just because it act like a sheep, a lot of leaders need to be careful. Be careful who you letting in your pulpit. Be careful who you allowing to speak over your people. Amen? Because some people just come in to rob the people. You know, a lot of people come to rob the people. Like I said, they're not concerned about the people's soul. They just want the money. Amen. And it's the truth anyhow. You got a lot of hirelings out here. You know, they worried about they pockets getting fat. They not worried about people's soul. Amen. So, like I said, you got false prophets. You got false teachers. You got false people coming. They're coming. People are on an assignment. People have agendas. And I'm telling you, when you have a call of God on your life, and when you make up in your mind that you want to do right for the Lord, don't think the distraction's not coming. Don't think the temptation's not coming. But God said that I've made a way of escape for you. You can go in that way of escape. And the scripture says that now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless unto the day of Jesus Christ. You know, God is a keeper. God can keep you if you want to be kept. So I just want to encourage you on tonight to beware of the camouflage. You got people that's trying to blend in and look like saints. They're trying to look like they're of God, or they're trying to look like, you know, they're coming with you know, that they have your best interest. Some people don't have your best interest. Some people coming on an assignment. They're coming, you know, starting off innocent. They're starting off saying the things that you want to hear. But all along, it's to get your demise. It's to trap you. It's to set you backwards so you don't move forward. So beware. Beware of your connections. Beware of who you allow in your ear. Beware of who you allow in your ear. You know, I even come against flattery in the name of Jesus. You know, there's a lot of seducing spirits, a lot of flattery, a lot of people telling you what you want to hear. You know, sometimes, you know, the devil will send men telling you how good you look, how beautiful you look. You need to already know you're beautiful. You need to already know that you're fearfully and wonderfully made. You know, men, that goes for the men too. You know, the devil will have assignments that'll come to you. Especially, you know, if you're a man of God with an assignment. Hallelujah. You got a lot of people that say they're saved. You got a lot of people that haven't been sent by God. You got a lot of people that's out here, they haven't been sent by God. The anointing of God, the call of God. God never gave them a charge to go out here. And people are out here, they playing with God's people. And I want to say that a lot of people out here playing, they weren't sent. A lot of people out here, you know, they're doing things in and of themselves. Like I said, they're building their own kingdoms. You know, they're trying to get people to do things the way they want them to do it and not do it according to the word of God. And if it's not lining up with the word of God, it's false and it's not of God. It's of the devil. Anything that's not lining up with God, you know, or the word of God, and it's to get you to, you know, tickle your flesh or to benefit the person or people, it's not of God. I don't care what it look like. I don't care who it's coming from. You know, you know, God said I would do the separating. You would know the wheat from the tare. You would know what's of God and what's not of him when you put your spiritual antennas up. Because if not, you will be deceived. The scripture talks about how the enemy will fool the very elect if it be possible. So that lets you know that if as Christians, if you're not careful, the devil can fool any of us. I don't care how deep you is. I don't care how great your title is. You know, you can still be deceived. You can still be hooked, weak, and duped if you're not on guard. If you're not, you know, paying attention to your surroundings. If you're not paying attention to what's being brought to you and presented to you. Amen. So I want to talk about that. To beware and be careful. Thank you, Lord. And Father, I just thank you on tonight. I thank you on tonight, God, how you anointing your people, God. I thank you how you anointing, God, in the name of Jesus, Father. I pull down every stronghold. I pull down everything that's not like you, God. I pull down everything that tries to set us up, your people. I come up against everything that comes to pull and distract us, God, in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you, Lord, that every trap, God, that the enemy sends, Father. Lord, I send a boomerang in the spirit, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. I thank you that the blood is applied over your people, oh God. I thank you that your people are standing, oh God. I thank you right now, God, that your people will know the real from the unreal, God. The holy and that's not unholy, that's not holy, God, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that you're causing your people to not touch the unclean thing, Father. In the name of Jesus, God, I thank you that you have called us to be separate, God, to come out from amongst them, Father. And I thank you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God, that you're doing something right now, God, even in this season, oh God. You're strengthening this discernment of your people, oh God. And Father, I thank you, Lord, that you're causing people to go deeper in prayer, Father. I thank you that you're causing people, God, to go before the throne, God, to lay prostrate in prayer, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. I thank you, Lord, that you're doing it even on tonight, oh God. I thank you, Lord, because God, many people are calling evil good and good evil, Father. And I thank you, Lord, that people are calling out things as they are, God. Father, if it's a devil, they're going to call it a demon, Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God. Father, I thank you, Lord, that people are lining up to your word, God. People are doing it your way and not their own way, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, Lord, that everything that's not of you, God, every counterfeit, God, every imitation, every camouflage spirit, God, that you're exposing it right now, oh God. You're exposing it in the ministries, oh God. You exposing it in families, God. You exposing it on the job, God. I thank you, Lord, that you exposing these spirits, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. And I thank you that you're giving your people wisdom. I thank you, oh God, I thank you that you're giving us wisdom, oh God, on how to deal with situations, God, how to deal with seducing spirits, oh God. I thank you for giving your people strategies, oh God. I thank you right now in the name of Jesus that we won't be hoodwinked and duped, God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. I thank you, Lord, that, Lord, that we will see the enemy from afar off, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Make us watchmen on the wall, God. I thank you, Lord, right now, God, that you're doing it in the name of Jesus, God. I pull down every seducing spirit. I pull it down, God. Every spirit that comes as an angel of light, God. I thank you, Lord. I cast it down right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you right now, oh God, that your people won't be deceived. Your people won't be fooled and tricked, God. In the name of Jesus, God, I thank you on tonight, God, that you're dealing with your people on tonight. God, you even showing faces, God, in the name of Jesus, God. I thank you for dealing with people in dreams, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, you've given people instructions. You've given people assignments. And God, I thank you, Lord, that they're standing firm. God, that they will not allow anything to hinder the move, God, that they will not allow anything to hinder what you have spoken to them, oh God, in the name of Jesus, God. Give your people strength to stand, Father. I thank you, Lord. I thank you right now, oh God, that you're doing it on tonight, Father. I thank you that you're strengthening singles right now, God. In the name of Jesus, God, you're strengthening people on tonight. You're strengthening single men and single women, Father. And God, you're even strengthening people in marriage, God. Because just because you're married don't mean that you're married, don't mean that the temptation stops, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, I thank you, Lord, that people are walking in that door of escape, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, I thank you, oh God, that you said, God, that we would know them by their fruit, God. In the name of Jesus, you said that a corrupt tree cannot bring forth good fruit, and you said neither can a good tree bring forth corrupt fruit, God. In the name of Jesus, oh God, I thank you, Lord, that we would be able to distinguish, God, what's of you and what's not of you, what's good and what's of evil, God. In the name of Jesus, Father, I thank you right now, oh God, that you're doing it for your people on tonight. I thank you, Lord. I thank you on tonight, God, in the name of Jesus. And you know what was so interesting on today? I knew I needed to get on here because one of my daughters, she had opened up a fortune cookie. She was eating and opened up a fortune cookie from a store, and it said on the fortune cookie to guard yourself because evil temptation was coming. And I'm telling you, I told her, I said, look, God speaks in so many ways. You know, God is so good that he will prepare us. God will warn us when the enemy is about to come, when the enemy is coming and he's lurking. Because the enemy is lurking. He's always lurking. The enemy studies us. The enemy knows how to distract. Amen. So we have to be mindful of the distractions. We have to be mindful of the tactics of the enemy. So just like he studies us, we have to study how he moves and try to move in our life so we're prepared. We have to be prepared with that word of God. We got to be prepared, you know, to counterattack him with prayer, to counterattack him with the word of God. So I just want to tell you that on tonight, to be careful and beware. Beware of the false spirits that are in the land. Beware. Beware of the counterfeit. Beware of the imitation. Beware of those spirits that's coming to camouflage and blend in and look like, you know, it's something that is not, you know, to camouflage the appearance and the character of, you know, but it's really not of God. Beware. Be careful. Have your discernment up. Have your guards up. Be prepared. Amen, because the devil is not playing. The devil is not playing. He is not playing. And today, you know, I saw something on Facebook, and then today somebody was talking about it. But how Delilah kept pressing Samson. She kept pressing and pressing and pressing him. She kept pressing him until he told her where his strength had lied. Where it lied, you know? And that's how the devil do. He'll keep pressing. He'll keep pressing. Even though he know, you don't want to do something, he keep pressing that issue, pressing that issue. He want to keep pressing you to do that thing that you know not to do, that you know would be displeasing to God. He just keep pressing. But when you make up in your mind and tell that devil, I'm standing. I'm standing. I don't care how hard it get. I'm telling you, ladies, I want to tell you, encourage you to stand. I'm talking to the ladies right now. I know men may say it's not just the ladies, but I'm telling the women to stay encouraged and to stand. To stand. I've had so many men that told me they are men of God, and their character was totally not of God. You know, and one thing I'm finding is when people, I've had this happen in the past, when people realize that you see them for who they really are, they can get afraid that you're going to expose them. You know, I'm not one to, you know, go out and try to put nobody down. You know, if I know something had taken place or you did something, I'm not one of them people that try to pull you down and shoot you down, put your name out, put your picture on Facebook. I don't do stuff like that because I just let God deal with you. But be careful, because again, just because somebody say they're of God or they're sent by God, that don't mean that it's of God. You know, the devil sent people too. So that went back to that definition. I got to say this because the counterfeit and imitation go hand in hand. I love this part about the counterfeit because it said it's not produced by the proper authorities. So everything that's coming your way saying, God brought me to you, or God sent me to you, it wasn't produced by God. Some things came from the devil, because every good and perfect gift comes from above without a shadow of turning. I'm going to tell you something, ladies. When God sends you the one that he has for you, he not coming trying to get a sexual relationship with you. That's not the kind of man God going to send you. I get me in our visual. I get that. I'm not that deep to not understand that. I get that a man would look at you, he would be attracted by you. But God ain't sending me no man that's trying to encourage me to sin. That's not the kind of man that Sheila want. You know, God know that I need a real man of God, because the call that's on my life, I need to know that this man can cover me in prayer. I need to know that this man can speak to my spirit and pour into me. Not a sexual thing. So I want to encourage you. So a lot of times when these people come, they telling on themselves already. So I want to encourage you, ladies, because you know what? If that relationship is just built that he want to get in your pants, no, he ain't been sent by God. The devil is a lie. You can get that in the street. I'm just keeping it real. If it was about sex, you can get that anywhere. But the man that God has for you, he's not encouraging you to go against God's will. He's not going to encourage you to do anything against God's word. He's going to be praying. Like I said, whatever that man ain't doing in dating, he's not going to do it in the marriage. So if he ain't praying, that's a strike for that. That's a red flag for me right there. If you come into me and you just met me, and you already asking me, you know, this is so degrading to me. I want to talk about this while I'm on this subject. But this videoing thing, you know, I don't video and send pictures and all that stuff. I don't do that. So when somebody asks me that, you have just insulted me, because I don't do that kind of stuff. I'm sorry, because that's, to me, when you start, when a person want to start videoing, you don't know me, you haven't even talked to me, you don't even want to talk to hear my voice on the telephone, you rather video call me, I'm not ready for you to look at me like that yet. You don't have a right to look at me right now. I don't think you've earned the fact to even video call me, to have that type of, you know, it just don't work like that for me, you know. So I want to talk about that, because, you know, you have to be careful. You have to guard yourself, because, you know, a lot of people doing stuff on these video calling and they tapping into perversion, you know. So a lot of times you may not be having physical sex, but if you're tapping into that kind of stuff where you want to send pictures and, you know, I had somebody tell me, they I want to see a picture of how they look as far as, you know, with their clothes on, as far as how they look. And they want to send me a picture without clothes. I said, no, thank you. I don't need all of that. You know, I need some things to be a mystery for me. You know, if that person's supposed to be for me, I don't need to see that. I'm not impressed by that. You know, I'm not attracted to that. You know, that don't mean that I don't have desires. That don't mean that when I get married, I don't want to have fun with my husband. But look, you got to know what you can and can't do. Because if I know that I can't have sex before marriage, there's certain things that I just can't do. As far as to get my spirit roused up, to get my flesh roused up. So God ain't sending you no man or no woman who's just coming with a fleshly appetite for you. They just want your body. They just want to get in your panties or your drawers. You know, that's not the kind of man that God gonna send you. That's not hard to distinguish. So I just want to talk about that, to be careful, to be mindful. So, you know, I'm out here right now. I just want to come here and talk about the false that's out here. There's a lot of false out here, and you got to be on guard. And that's pretty much all I want to talk about. I pray that you guys have a blessed evening and have a blessed night.